Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. How are you all? I hope that you are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Alhamdulillah, I'm also fine. Welcome to NIEVS Home School. This is Mr. Rabiul Islam, Assistant Teacher of Islamic Studies of National Ideal University School, Morning Shift. Today I'm going to take an Islamic Studies class for class 9, and our today's topic is Chapter 1, Lesson 5, Discussion. And my dear students, today is our lecture number 5 and SW number 5. Inshallah, my dear students, today we will discuss from Chapter 1 from Lesson 5. So, my dear students, let's start at first look at the board. Dear students, here, Lesson 1, Chapter 1, Lesson 5, the topic is the identity of Allah, the Most High. So, my dear students, let's start. Allah, the Most High, is the Lord and owner of the universe. He is one and without any rival. He does not have any partner. He is unique and incomparable. His incomparable feature is explicit in His very name, Allah. The word Allah has written the name Allah in Arabic. The word Allah is Arabic. No language of the world contains its exact synonym. It has got no plural form, no male-female variants. This word is both unique and incomparable. So Allah is the Most High. He is one and only in His essence and attributes. There is nothing as His rival or equivalent. Allah the Most High declares, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Qul huwa Allahu ahad, Allahu samad, lam yalid wa lam yulad, wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. Meaning, speak, O Prophet, He is Allah, one and only. He is not dependent on anyone. All are dependent on Him. He begets none, nor is He begotten. And there is none like Him. Surah Al-Ikhlas verses, my dear students, you know that from 1 to 4. That means Surah Al-Ikhlas has only 4 verses. Okay, my dear students, we have learned that there is no God but Allah. Allah, here is the Surah Ikhlas. By reading Surah Ikhlas, we know that Allah is not dependent on anyone. All are dependent on Him. So, my dear students, here is the another identity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here is the another ayat Allah has said in the Holy Quran. Allah the Most High says, Huwa al-awwalu wal-akhiru wal-zahiru wal-batin wa huwa bikulli shayin alim. Meaning, He is the first, He is the last, He is the manifest, He is concealed and He is well conversant in all matters. Surah Al-Hadid ayat verses 3 ayat or verses number 3. And my dear students, in another place, Allah the Most High declares, here is the another identity, identification for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for Allah the Most High. Allah has said in the Holy Quran, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum, la ta'kuduhu sinatum wa la nawm, lahu ma fis samawati wa ma fil ard. And my dear students, you know that this part has been taken from the verses number 225, Surah Al-Baqarah. And my dear students, you know that this ayat is called Ayatul Kursi. Ayatul Kursi. And you will get this verse in the Holy Quran in Surah Baqarah, verses number 225. Okay, my dear students, now we'll read the meaning. He is Allah, there is none except Him worthy of worship. He is ever living and sustains all other things. Sleep or androgynous can never touch him. Everything in heaven and on earth is subservient to him. That means, my dear students, you know that Allah need not to take any food, Allah need not to take any sleep. Allah is one, Allah is only, He is our creator. And my dear students, you know that Allah was and Allah is and Allah will be. Okay, my dear students, now look at the board again. Allah the Most High is the repository of all virtues. All dwell in Him. All dwell in Him in the fullest measure. He is the creator, the universe with all its properties. He is His creation. He is the sustainer. All creatures are dependent on Him for sustenance. So, my dear students, now look at the last two lines. In fact, Allah the Most High is one and unique in His essence and attributes. He has got no partners. Allah praises are due to Him. The only entity worthy of worship is He. My dear students, Alhamdulillah, today we have learned the identity of Allah the Most High. My dear students, we all know that Allah is our creator, Allah is our sustainer, Allah is our Razzaq, that means food provider, Allah is kind, Allah is very kind, that means Allah Rahim, and Allah is, we know that Allah is Khaliq, that means Allah is creator. And my dear students, we know that Allah need not take any food, Allah need not sleep anything. And my dear students, Alhamdulillah, we have also learned that Allah is a word that is unique. There is no plural form of Allah. And my dear students, there is no male and female word for this word. So Allah is unique. My dear students, we know that Allah was, Allah is, and Allah will be. So my dear students, we know that Allah has created all of the jinn and human beings only for His ibadat. So my dear students, we should always perform ibadat to only of Allah, to only worship of Allah. And my dear students, we will do this. May Allah grant us everyone tawfiq. We'll say Ameen. Okay, my dear students, that's all for today. And now your SW is SW number 5. You will make SW at your home from these two pages, from page 11 to 12. From here, my dear student, from lesson 5, KBQ, that means knowledge based question, any 5. Any 5, you will make SW from page number 11 and 12, KBQ, knowledge based question, any 5. Okay, my dear students, that's all for today, inshallah. See you again very soon. Till then, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.